smiley faces. Please have a smile on your face quickly. Yeah, and if possible, laugh for 2 minutes, actually. That's one of the important things that we've almost forgotten: smiling, laughing, giggling, and having fun. All right, with a happy note, I begin my lecture today, which is on overcoming depression. To give a small introduction, I work as a counseling psychologist for Tata Institute of Social Science. I am also trained in rational emotive behavior therapy. Okay, I have a PowerPoint presentation to explain a few things today. To begin with, I'll just give you a definition, which seems to be a little theoretical, but theory is important. Only then can we proceed to practical part of it. Just to know about depression, some people say that depression feels like a black curtain of despair. It is a lot of sadness, distress, hopelessness. Many of them feel like there is no energy and can't concentrate. Yeah, a clinical side to the definition, which says that if you're feeling sad, irritated, distressed for a longer period of time, maybe 2 weeks or more than that, then that is considered to be depression. There are moments of sadness in everyone's life. So those moments, if we overcome in half an hour, 1 hour, in a day's time, in an evening's time, no, it cannot be claimed as depression. For people to acquire depression, they have to be sad, be irritable, be frustrated, be distressed for a longer period of time. Now, when we say or use the term depression in clinical area, it generally has medical intervention as a technique to overcome. Okay, now this medical intervention is carried out by, as we all know, psychiatrists or doctors, who give you antidepressants. In simple words, they prescribe medicines. All right, now today we are not going to address the medical intervention part of this, because we are all common people with problems such as irritation, distress, a lot of stress, nervousness, sadness in our lives, which we want to overcome. But in the beginning, I would just want you all to know that if suppose need be, you're always welcome to visit doctors and psychiatrists and seek medical intervention, medical help as well. Okay, now today, as I said earlier, we may not go into the medical part, but we'll try to see what can be done at our own homes, at our own offices, at our own that can be done in our daily activities. All right? Now, everyone has a different view on depression. What happens is, there have been many psychologists, there have been many psychiatrists, there have been professors of psychology who have given their own views. Okay, I have tried to differentiate two categories. First one comes with a view that depression is a disability and not a choice. That means it is something that you have no control or no much control over. All right? People do not normally choose to depress themselves. They do not choose. It happens to them, is one view. The second view is you largely construct your depression. It is not given to you. It is not something that automatically happens to you. It is something that you create for yourself. Now, these are quite contradictory views, but they are equally recognized. Yeah, we'll see why. The second view given by Dr. Albert Ellis. Now he's an REBT practitioner. That is, he's a rational emotive behavior therapist practitioner. So according to him, he's a very action-oriented, you know, and a firm believer in humans' ability to either develop or destruct self. Now, the first viewpoint comes with the belief that certain bodies or certain human beings have a tendency already, you know, we call it disposition, you know, of undergoing chemical changes which causes feelings and emotions such as sadness, frustration, and that causes depression. Hereditary, yes, it comes. Now, these are the views. We cannot say only one of them is correct, but both are recognized and both are applicable. A checklist for depression would be, obviously it affects all the areas. It affects your body, it affects your mood and your thoughts. Now, what is body? It affects the way we eat, sleep, no? Then we look drowsy at times, no? We don't look fresh, yeah? We don't look happy, yeah? We don't look active. And mood. When it affects our mood, we generally tend to feel bad, feel sad. When depression affects our thinking, what happens is we begin thinking negatively. We begin thinking unhealthily. Alright, so depression affects body, mood and thinking of a person at the same time. Alright, a easier way to check whether a person is depressive for, you know, people like us who may not have, I won't say time to consult a doctor, but in case if we just want to judge ourselves whether we are depressed or whether somebody from our family or from our workplace is having some depressive tendencies and needs to seek out help, then a checklist kind of process is there, which can be helpful in detecting whether the person is undergoing depressive feelings. Now, there are certain questions. I would like if the lights get switched off. Otherwise, it's not very visible. Yeah, can we read now? Is it? Yes. Do you feel sad or suffer from blues? Now, this is if it happens very often. Do you many a times feel sad? Are you always in the blue mood? Not very interested about life. Not very interested in yourself. Not others. Then, do you get little or no enjoyment from daily activities? Even if I'm working every day, there's no enjoyment at the end of it. No, it's just that a routine which I have to follow only because of some pressure. Yeah? Now, there are quite a few questions. If you want to refer them, we can refer, but I'll just move ahead, no? Because the rest, I guess, is more important. And that is techniques to overcome depression. Because this is something that we have all come for today, to get the techniques, to know the techniques. Okay? Now, I've tried to categorize techniques into four major categories. First being cognitive techniques, the second behavioral techniques, emotive techniques and distraction techniques. What are cognitive techniques? The word cognitive comes from cognition. And cognition means thinking, the process of thinking. It includes your thoughts and the process in which our thoughts are created, remain, and then cause different reactions. Yeah, so thinking implies cognition, and under cognitive techniques, it is mentioned that there are specific strategies to change and modify unhelpful or negative thoughts concerning a particular event. For example, learning to change one's thoughts to cope better with one's depression. That means, according to cognitive approach, if a person changes his thinking, no, and especially negative thinking, the unhealthy thinking which is causing harm to him, definitely there will be improvement in the mood, the bodily aspect, and as well as thinking. The person might feel good, the person might look good, and the person might think good. Yeah. Now, under cognitive techniques, to just give you a brief idea right now, there are different therapies. One of them is REBT, the other one is CBT. We'll talk in details about it a bit later, because that will need a detailed explanation. Behavior techniques. How do we know it is different from cognitive techniques? Remember, the cognitive techniques focus more on thinking, thought process. Behavior techniques will focus on changing the behavior of the person. So, if I have a habit of smoking, I better stop the behavior. If I have a habit of waking up late, I better stop that behavior. Yeah? So, behavioral change. Now, the behavioral change doesn't take place easily. No, if it has become your habit, no, it needs techniques such as either rewarding good behavior, desirable behavior. For example, supposing you want to wake up early. For that, what you can do is every day when you wake up on time set for yourself, or when you wake up early, no, you can either reward yourself by giving something that you want, or else